And Maple Leafs have been doing that very well.
Good day, YouTube viewers, subscribers, friends, whoever. Welcome in to a Tits Beer Bong 420 beer review. We're going to be looking at a Lake of Bays beer here in their NHL Alumni Series. They got one in the can, and then they got four in the bottle. Let me tell you about their series first off. The one in the can that came out was a top shelf. It was in like a pint size or a little bit smaller size glass. And yeah, all the reviews on it were just like mine. It like hit people in the top of their teeth with a really shitty, nasty taste. We all didn't like it because it's a craft brewery trying to make this really cheap, crappy, non-craft lager, and it was terribly made and horrible. Now, the rest they came out with have all been in huge bottles ever since and cost lots of money. They did one with Cujo. It was an 8% Imperial Ale. It's discontinued. I've never had it. I don't even know if I've ever seen that one around. I've been kind of scared to try out these ones because how the last one was. Ugh, I don't want to pay the price. There's another one that I don't know which locations have it, but I looked on our liquor store's website. It doesn't say it's discontinued or limited or whatever, so somebody must still have some. But with some old hockey player, they made a Dark Oktoberfest lager at 8%. Now, the latest one is Toronto Maple Leaf themed. They call it Crazy Eyes with Darcy Tucker. It's supposed to be a winter dark bock at like 8% in limited qualities. That's the recent one that's out. The one I have is listed as on the website as product discontinued. It was a gift given to me over the holidays. The people that gave it to me, the location that they got it in, they were being told it's the recent one. But no, it's not the recent one. It might even be expired. Who knows? Now, where did I put the bottle? I put it down somewhere, and now I don't see it. Oh, here it is. Good day, YouTube, and welcome into a Tits Beer Bong 420 beer review. We're going to be looking at a big, big bottle here, Lake of Bays. This one here is Jake the Snake. Jacques Plante or whatever, signature NHL Alumni Series Imperial Pilsner, 7.5% alcohol. Wood aging takes a non-traditional turn with this very special Imperial Pilsner. White ash brings out the smoothness of Vienna malt as well as the spicy, bittering qualities of Columbus and Chinook hops. Now, I didn't see any reviews up online for it, but blog reviews, people that drank it in December are saying like it's old and they're thinking it gone bad or some crap. So I don't know, it could be expired by now because the date on it is 7 months and 4 days back from the day I'm reviewing it, but it doesn't explain if that's like the bottling date or the best before date. I was thinking of saving this one for a later time, but because of what I'm hearing about people who had it in December, and knowing that it might not be in its fresh date anymore, and we got hockey games to switch back and forth to, NHL and whatnot, we'll review it. So 7.5% Imperial Pilsner, Masked Men Edition 3. Lake of Bays Brewing Company Limited, Bayville's, Ontario. Water, malted barley, wheat, and hop. And it looks so clear in front of the TV. And it's got the signature on it. Production run 12,300. So, whatever. I gotta get my glass now, it looks like. Not cheap when they're in the big, big bottles. Sorry about the lot of talking, but here we go. Cheers. Oh, smell from the bottle first? Just smells like a typical Pilsnery lager, something I've definitely smelled like a billion times before. Cheers. And this bottle's almost full all the way. And that was a bad, bad pour. It's all head, basically. That came out quick. Yeah, it's so bubbly on the inside. So from what's forming up, slow carbonation, small amounts, golden imperial Pilsner at 7.5%. So I'll check the time on the camera, take a snapshot in a moment, get into the review. It's going to be a long video, folks. So Jake the Snake, the one themed after this Quebec hockey player, which they have a story of before the fucking talk about the beer, but we're not going to get into it. A lighter gold imperial pilsner, lots of head, slow, very slow carbonation, lots of it though, in a way, like medium style. So many fucking Vienna style lagers smell like this, so many other kind of lagers smell like this. This is a familiar smell. It just smells light, little smell of the hops, some smell of the malt, but everything just smells like a lager I smelled before. Cheers. Nowhere near as disgusting as the Top Shelf beer, thank fucking God. But how in the fuck is this 7.5%? It just seems like it's very like light, watery, buttery, very buttery or something, and then those Columbus and Chinook hops give it this little bitterness in the back. But apparently the Imperial Pilsners, the amount of malt they put in it do mask some of the hoppiness. But it's like malty, buttery, watery. It tastes like it's 4%, not 7.5. Way better than fucking Top Shelf. But you don't have to pay for it like I did. Way better of a deal. Not really worth getting, but worth over Top Shelf. Wonder how the other ones are. I would like to try Darcy Tucker. And the other two, you may or may not be able to get them anymore. So for you stoners, and so I can catch more of a buzz, enjoy some bongers with this beer. Okay, intermission. We'll be winding the video down now. Some bong rips. If you're not into that stuff, you can sign out. The beer, the whole bottle will get you a buzz, I guess, but it's so easy to drink quickly. Doesn't taste like it's strong. Nothing good about Lake of Bay lagers. They're either easy to forget or they're very nasty. And they make too many of them. And that's pricey, and it was a gift, and Max Domi almost got a goal there. Damn. Carnival. There was ice in the top earlier, but like, it melts in the bowl. And then you have to remove some of the water, so you got a good hit. And I've got to like shake the cleaner more than I'm using, or keep it in longer. Hopefully I'll get all the resin out at some point. Huge amount of lacing on the glass. Fire in the hole. As you see the glass, the port's finished. It's not worthy of its price or the bottle size, but it was a gift for me. It may or may not be anything special. Or I mean, expired, sorry. I'm gonna sum it up. It tastes poor, but it's 7.5%. Watery, easy drinking. Buttery, some malt, and just a little bit of the Chinook and Columbus hops can be tasted, but they don't seem to do anything too exciting. Peace.